Brian from @BeyondEarth buckle up with a look at one of our favorite X-15 test pilots from NASA's Flight Research Center. In 1955, Neil Armstrong joined NASA's Flight Research Center at Edwards, California as a research pilot, a place where only the most daring and skilled aviators tested the cutting-edge aircraft of the Cold War era. There, he took to the skies in nearly every jet fighter in the legendary Century series, each flight pushing the limits of speed, power, and precision. These missions sharpened Armstrong's skills, setting him on the path to make history beyond Earth's atmosphere. He piloted the F-100, the F-101, the F-102, the F-104, and the F-105. He also piloted the F-5D, the KC-135, the B-47, and his first flight was in the P-51. During this period, Armstrong took on the high-stakes role of launch pilot aboard a heavily modified B-29, releasing the experimental X-1E rocket plane from altitude, a job requiring pinpoint precision at every launch. He also piloted the revolutionary X-5, the first aircraft able to adjust its wing sweep mid-flight. This groundbreaking technology, tested by Armstrong, paved the way for the variable geometry wings still in use today on powerful jets like the F-14 Tomcat and B-1 Bomber. At the Flight Research Center, Neil Armstrong took on exhilarating flights in the X-1B, a rocket-powered marvel that roared through the skies at speeds reaching 1,600 miles per hour, pushing both man and machine to the edge. In 1958, he was selected as one of the elite seven pilots for the legendary X-15 program, a groundbreaking project that would go on to become the most celebrated rocket-powered research aircraft in history. With a specialty in stability and control, Armstrong worked hand-in-hand with engineers to pioneer an adaptive flight control system that would allow the X-15 to reach near-orbital altitudes. He personally piloted the first four flights using this breakthrough technology in the number 3 X-15, proving its capability under the most extreme conditions. His work on this system earned him the esteemed Octave Chanute Award from the AIAA. Although the X-15 was initially designed in the 1950s to expand humanity's knowledge of hypersonic flight, it ultimately became a critical stepping stone for manned space exploration, opening doors to the cosmos. The X-15 program showcased the extraordinary versatility and resilience of human pilots, who had to rely on a powerful combination of skill, intuition, and split-second decision-making to master the unknown. Launched mid-air from as far as 300 miles out, the X-15's rocket engine roared to life for a blistering 90 seconds before its fuel ran out. After that, the aircraft climbed like a missile, soaring to altitudes over 300,000 feet and tearing through the atmosphere at more than 6 times the speed of sound. Each flight was a thrilling test of human capability in the face of unimaginable speed and altitude. Despite the extreme speeds and altitudes, X-15 pilots consistently showcased remarkable precision, guiding their hypersonic glider to land within just 1,000 feet of their target. Even with the unpredictability of high-speed flight, and unless met with unexpected mechanical issues, these pilots brought their craft down with pinpoint accuracy, mastering one of the most challenging landings in aviation history. In the early 1960s, Neil Armstrong delved into pioneering efforts on a bold new concept for spacecraft recovery, a deployable paraglider that could gently return both manned and unmanned spacecraft to Earth. Although initially promising, further testing revealed practical challenges, ultimately making the paraglider more suitable for recreational hang gliding than for space missions. Around this same period, Armstrong was at the controls of a prototype jet fighter, where he devised an innovative rescue technique for abort scenarios in a new manned spacecraft under development. His work brought critical insights that would shape the future of space mission safety. This ambitious project, known as the X-20 Dyna-Soar, was designed for the US Air Force as an early space plane, aiming to bridge the gap between atmospheric flight and space missions. Launched atop a powerful Titan III booster, the X-20 would have soared into orbit and used a technique called dynamic soaring, an advanced concept originally developed by German engineers during World War II, to maneuver through the upper atmosphere. After completing its mission in space, the Dyna-Soar would re-enter Earth's atmosphere, gliding back down to land like a sleek, futuristic aircraft. In all, Neil logged 2,600 flight hours in over 900 flights at Edwards, and all before becoming the most famous astronaut of all time. This was one of the most exciting places in the world at that time. The flight test world was filled with excitement. Dozens and dozens of new concepts and configurations and tests, something new to talk about every day. And I believe that whenever I have the privilege of visiting here again, in years ahead, and ask someone, what's new, there'll always be something. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe to our channel at Beyond Earth Buckle Up for more captivating space history. Remember to take care of one another and always keep looking up. Thank you.